baseball fans, and welcome. MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the Cleveland Guardians and the Detroit Tigers. With my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Schaub. And Singy, there's been a lot to talk about already in this series as we head into game four.
And I'll be interested to see if these teams approach it any differently, with one on the brink of elimination and the other just a win away from putting an end to this thing. You know, in the postseason, I think you have to treat every game the same, but there's something about an elimination game that could put a team just into a different mindset.
Yeah, and the strategy could certainly change in this type of game. It's hard to manage the same way when in any given at bat, it can impact everything you've been working for throughout the season. First pitch coming your way next. So just about set now. Our starter in this one, Reese Olson. What do we have on him?
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss. Going to count one and two.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand looks so good. And then by the time it gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
Righty delivers. Foul ball still, one and two count. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. So now the DH spot, Kyle Manzardo. And there's a foul ball. A wind in the pitch. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. One down, base is empty. And that's there's a ball. Bolton. Into center, on the move. And there's two down. Here's the Guardians lineup now. Singy, we're looking at a really young lineup here, so not much experience, but it also means they're going to bring a lot of energy to the table most days.
Well, we're in a golden age of young players. I mean, these players, they're getting up to the majors. They're dominating from a young age, bringing home plenty of hardware early in their careers. I mean, before they even get to free agency. So, you know, when you consider all of that, I love seeing the kind of energy that a team like this brings to the yard every day, day in and day out.
Two outs, base is empty. Guardians go down 1-2-3, and now the Tigers get their first opportunity. No score. You're watching the American League Division Series on The Show. Back here with my pal Singy, and towing the slab, Tanner Bibee. How about a scouting report on him?
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
Now into the ball game on defense. Number 10, he takes over and right.
Number 10, Daniel.
Here's the center fielder, Akil Baddoo.
Leading up for the Tigers, the center fielder, Akil Baddoo.
Ground ball nailer. And he takes it himself for the out.
Batting second.
Let's take a check of the Tigers lineup. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
Boog, if they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
That one finds the zone, and the count is 2-2. And a swing and a miss down on strikes here tonight. An efficient start to the home first, two away. Two outs, bases empty. Matt Vierling digs in now. Here comes a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Tigers fail to make any noise. We played an inning. No score. New inning getting started. And now it's Josh Naylor.
Number 22, Josh Naylor.
One and two now. And another ball. The pressure is high for the players in the postseason, but maybe even higher for the managers. Every decision you make is critical to the success of the team and to your own reputation. And down on strikes. And one out now.
Well, just a beautiful fastball on the inside corner for that backwards K right there. I think the hitter saw it all the way. Coming from that opposite arm angle, so I got to think he was looking away and just got locked up by the hard stuff boring in on his hands.
One ball, two strikes.
The pitch. And that skips in the dirt.
Well, for better or worse, managers are remembered for what they do in the postseason. Pull the right strings, they might build a statue of you someday. One bad decision, and you might be updating your resume. You've got to be sharp.
The pitch. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
That is it. The second baseman, Andre Jimenez.
Here's Andres Jimenez. Here goes the runner. Pitch is high. Throw, save. That's a stolen base.
You know what? I like the aggressiveness right there. It looks like it's going to be tough to score in this one. Really good pitching so far. So why not try to put some pressure on him and see if you can steal the bag, get in the scoring position.
One out and a runner at second here in game four. And he can't make the play, but plenty of time to recover, and that's the second out.
Not a bad outcome in that spot. The runner moves up to third, and now they have a chance to drive in the go-ahead run. It's not a knock, but at the end of the day, it's a good at-bat.
Here's the rookie right fielder. Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did. Next offering misses down and away. Bo Naylor next to bat for Cleveland. Two outs and a runner at third here in game four of this ALDS. Out of bounds right side, Torkelson. And that is that. One left for the Guardians. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Of the second. Now here's the Tigers cleanup hitter, Kerry Carpenter.
Kerry Carpenter.
Carpenter. The 1-2. And that just misses. Eric Summersgill, our plate umpire.
One thing to watch out for, Boog, is what side of the plate Summersgill might be favoring. He usually sets up at an angle. Pitchers sometimes will try to figure that out early so they can attack that spot and get as many strike calls as possible.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
He had him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
So digging in, Colt Keith. And he deals. Got him. Two out.
Well, he's really dialed in, and this offense is going to have to do something to try to break that rhythm. Maybe it's square around the blunt, step out of the box, agitate him a little bit, do something that just changes what's happening right now, because at this pace, it's going to be a long game, so you got to figure it out quickly.
Spencer Torkelson up now for the Tigers. Two outs.
Thank you.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Lifted in the air out to left. And base hit.
That's a ball that a lot of times you'll see the shortstop or left fielder be able to get to if it hangs up in the air long enough. But right there, it just died and found a way to drop in on the green stuff for base hit.
The pitch. And downstairs, Trey Sweeney up next for the Tigers. Now a screamer into the outfield. Martinez makes the catch, and that is that. Tigers lead one. We'll move to the third with no score. Out of the third inning, Bo Naylor at the plate now. And Chris, his big strength is defense. But it is interesting, in today's world of baseball compared to when you played, a good defensive catcher is considered differently.
Whatever you get offensively is a bonus, but he's got to put the fingers down. He's got to present pitches to the umpire. They're going to help his pitcher get more strikes.
Here's Brian Rocchio. One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss, struck him out. So the batting order turns over. Angel Martinez now at the plate. Not even close there. And that's ball two. Top of the third, no score. In the air, left field. Green going after it. Calls it into Indiana. Home half of the third coming up, no score. Back here in Detroit, bottom of the inning. Now it's the shortstop, Trey Sweeney. The shortstop takes a ball. Next offering is in for a strike. Left-hand hitter waits. Just missed.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
three.
Got him looking. One gone here.
Well, he throws him with the changeup right there, and I think he was so geared up for fastball once he recognized that it was off speed. He just wasn't able to make an adjustment. So a really good strikeout, and pitcher just won the battle.
Next offering is downstairs. Righty to the plate. That one hit to right. Sizing this one up. And there are two down.
Now batting. The center fielder.
Akil Badu up now for the Tigers. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. That one finds the corner, and a count 1-2.
Look, this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths.
Chases the fastball up the ladder, struck him out. Down in order go the Tigers, and we're still knotted at zero. Game four of the division series. Now the number two hitter, Kyle Manzardo. And the right-hander deals. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
The 1-2. And another ball. Wouldn't chase that time.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Right-hander kicks, deals. In the air, left side. Green settles under it, puts it away for the out. And there's one away.
Now
it's Jose Ramirez.
For me, Boog, Ramirez has been the heart and soul of Cleveland baseball for a few years now. When his career is over, he's going to be considered one of the best players to ever play for this franchise.
On the ground, right side, Keith. Slings to first, and Ramirez is set down.
Deceptive slider right there, stayed in the tunnel a long time, got that hitter out front, rolled over it, put it on the ground.
Here's Josh Naylor. Way out front for strike two.
One ball. He's gotten into a really good rhythm, set down seven in a row. He just wants to get the baseball and deliver it as quickly as possible. Keep the momentum going.
Two down, nobody on. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Swings and misses, struck him out. Nothing doing for the Guardians there. Still no score. And we're back. Leading bottom of the fourth. Better batter now. Riley Green. And a pitch. Hit on the ground to the right side. And it finds its way through for a hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Just one of those seen-eye base hits through the infield. It just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
Matt Vierling up now for the Tigers. That one missed. That fastball for a strike. With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here. All tied up. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Ripped on a line. Brings it in.
The batter, the designated hitter, Kerry Carpenter.
Now it's the DH, Kerry Carpenter. Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play. Runner on the move. Cut out and missed. The throw, tag, and he's out.
You know, sometimes a throw that bounces into second base can be just as good as a perfect throw in the air. Almost a little bit easier to handle at second base. For me, that caught stealing right there was all about a really poor jump off first. Just didn't time it well, and he was toast after that.
That one hammered left field, back there. Over the wall, and that's an automatic double.
That ball exploded off his bat and off the warning track as well as it bounced over the fence. It sounded really good, too. He just put together a really nice swing and just missed a home run.
Man in scoring position with two away. Colt Keith up now for the Tigers. And another ball.
Well, they're looking to get on the board first here after that clutch two-out double made this inning interesting.
Man at second. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. Not close with that one, and it's 3-2. Spencer Torkelson waiting to hit for Detroit. Carpenter at second with two down. And that's ball four.
Got a great back and forth in that at bat. Did play off some really close pitches. And somehow, Boogie found a way to keep the bat on the shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Spencer Torkelson up now for the Tigers. Two on, two outs. Out there to center. He's got it. And that is out number three. Tigers strand a pair, and we are still scoreless. Ready now for the fifth inning. Here's Lane Thomas. He's a guy, Chris's highlights include some of the best throws from the outfield that you will ever see. Definitely one of the best arms of the sport. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Puts it away for the out. One away.
Up next to Cleveland, the second baseman.
Andrés Giménez, the next to hit. Base is empty, one away, and we're at the top of the fifth. Check swing, tried to hold up. Now an appeal to third. No swing, he held up. Carl Dixon with the call there. And a 2-1 on the way. Well, chase that time.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count. Be ready to turn on a fastball.
The wind of the pitch. Inside ball four.
The right fielder, number 10.
Runner on at first with one gone. And now the right fielder. Check on the runner. Giménez back in on a dive. The 1-1. And that one fouled off. Runner on the go. Stays alive. Man at first, one away. Ah. struck him out. Pulled the string on the changeup. Bo Naylor digs in for the Guardians. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. Rudder takes off. Next offering is fouled back. The 1-2. Fights it off. You'll see another. In the air, out towards right center. Badu sizes this one up. He's got it. And that is that. Guardians lead one. Halfway through this one, still no score. Back at Comerica Park. Now it's going to be Jace Young. The line to the pitch. On the ground, out to short. Over to first. And the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth.
Now batting shortstop, Trey Sweeney
getting ready to hit. One down, base is empty. That one finds the zone. It's a ball and two strikes. He goes down looking.
Oh, definitely a borderline pitch right there, and he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. You know, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
Jake Rogers up now for the Tigers. Two outs. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout. Three up, three down for Detroit. Sixth inning coming up. Still nothing on the scoreboard. And welcome back to the ballpark. All set for the start of the inning. Stepping in is the switch hitting shortstop, Ryan Rocchio. The pitch. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. The pitch.
Ball, that pitch is out.
He doubled up on the off speed there. We talk about the power fastball, but he's working a little differently here.
And that's outside. That one drilled left field. And in one hops the wall. Around first and hustling for second. Green hurries it back in. They hold the runner at second, so another base hit could get us our first run in this one.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
Now at the plate, Angel Martinez. Comes up empty. That's strike two. And the righty deals. And another ball. Two two now. Bows it back with two strikes. swinging. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away. And next is the designated hitter, Kyle Manzardo. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. And it's one and two.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Waves at the bender for the strikeout. So back-to-back strikeouts now, and they still haven't managed to do anything with the leadoff double.
Yeah, Bogey, and you just don't want to get careless here. You've done a really good job to get two outs after that leadoff double, as you mentioned, and just got to execute your pitches, and it's a non-issue.
Here's Jose Ramirez. Man on second, two down. So now one and two. And a pitch. That ball is foul, and the pressure is building. Next offering upstairs.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
Go ahead, run at second, and we're at the top half of the sixth. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
A lot of adrenaline, we can see it right there, and sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
Back here in Detroit, bottom of the sixth inning, and here's the Tiger leadoff man, Akil Badu. Left-hand batter waits. Now this is in the air down the line. Should have this one. Makes the grab, one down.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Number 31.
Here's Riley Green.
Green.
One down, base is empty. On the ground, right side. And it gets by him. Matt Wierman will hit next.
Boom, the runner at first needs to be careful right here. He's dealing with the pickoff artist on the mound.
Tim Herron up and throwing. Number 36 getting loose as well. With the go-ahead run at first here in the bottom of the sixth. Line drive, base hit. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great. Runner in scoring position now, and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
So now here's the DH, Kerry Carpenter. Just off the inside corner. And the count's full.
At the dish, looking to look the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, dude.
Green over at second. Beerlin at first. One gone. Here comes a 3-2. Bows that off to the left, and we'll do it again.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Three balls, two strikes, the count. And a swing and a miss. He didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout.
So far, just one of those days for this lineup. You get a couple of runners on, and you're looking at having a big inning, and that strikeout right there just pours water on the fire. Look for the next hitter to step up and try to do something, pick up his teammate and his club.
So two down now, and here is Colt Keith. Right side, and that chance handled in plenty of time to first, gets him easily, ends the inning. Make it six shutout innings for him out there now. No score. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, number 62.
Bringing in the lefty with the left-handed hitter coming up to hit. Classic bullpen move right here, so we'll see how it works out.
And here's the first baseman, Josh Naylor.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
And now the lefty, that one fouled off. Kicks and deals.
Oh, that's it.
And there's a ball. Strikes for the third straight at bat.
Just couldn't catch up on the low 90s fastball right there. That's a result of a good job of changing speeds. Off-speed pitch on the one before, then sped him up. Pitchers that don't throw real hard have to rely on location and mixing up the speeds. That wasn't the best location with the fastball, but clearly that wasn't the pitch he was looking for at the plate either.
Stepping in, Lane Thomas. Fouls one off. 2-2. One down, base is empty. Just misses the mark outside the zone. Activity in the bullpen for Detroit. Alex Lang getting loose for A.J. Hinch. Brisky also throwing. Three and two now. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, that's a really dangerous base runner to put on first, especially in a tie game. Now there might be some consequences coming from that mistake.
And up next for Cleveland, Andrés Giménez.
Well, with pretty good speed over there at first base, I think the pitcher's got to slow everything down. Hold the ball a little bit, step off, just try to break the rhythm and timing of a potential base stealer.
Throws it away! Runner takes off. There's a ball. And safe. It's a stolen base. That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed, and he needed every last bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
Kicks and fires. That missed ball. And that's ball three.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
Man at second. Towards first, and it goes just foul.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit's probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
And a swing and a miss. Two gone now.
Nice work there to get the strikeout, and that's a big second out. I'll tell you, this home crowd will be fired up. They can get out of this and leave that go-ahead run stranded in scoring position. This is a big moment in this game.
Now it's the right fielder. Out to short. Oh, can't pick it up cleanly. And no shot to get him at first. There's two aboard. And here's the catcher, Bo Naylor. With the go-ahead run at third, late here in game four. That one back up the middle, and it gets through. Runner from third in to score. And they've taken the lead here in game four.
Well, they strike first as he gets the job done to bring home the run. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
So two down, Brian Rocchio digs in for the Guardians. Cleveland up a run, looking for more. Big swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
Two on, two outs. That one is upstairs. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Two outs. Missed with a changeup. Three and two now.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
And they're all loaded up. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
Now that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
Now the left fielder, Angel Martinez. And a pitch. Fouls one away, and now three and two. Two outs, bases are full. Gets a piece and stays alive. And here it comes. Got him swinging. So one run in the inning on this base hit. And the home team down a run. This is the American League Division Series on the show. And we're back, and here is Spencer Torkelson.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
Looking to get the tying run on base. Right through there for a strike.
So what we're seeing is a lineup that's just out of sync with the pitcher. They're guessing wrong, and their timing's off.
That one out to right. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One up, one down. Jace Young up now for the Tigers. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Two down.
This pitcher's done a good job of disrupting the hitter's timing with the mix of pitches and changing speeds. You want to keep that front foot inconsistent for the batter. Their swings are hesitant, and that's exactly what you want on the mound.
And now, Trey Sweeney. The 1-1. Called a foul. Two down, nobody on. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. Tigers are shut down there. They still trail 1-0. Bo Brisky into the game.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Well, one run game. Stepping up for the Guardians, Kyle Mansardo. 2-1 now. That one missed.
Three balls, one strike.
Headed down the line on the move towards foul ground. Flashes the leather on the running catch.
And there's one away.
Outstanding catch right there, and I love the commitment that he showed. He knew that the wall was close, but was determined to make that catch, and a nice calculation of just how much room he had to try to minimize that contact.
And that's outside. Swings and misses. 2-2. Bounced up the middle. Whips it to first. And Ramirez is set down.
The first base is number 22, Josh Naylor.
And now the first baseman, Josh Naylor. Two outs. He swings and fouls one off. Two down, nobody on, and we're in the top of the eighth. And look out, as that one ran in and got him. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch. So in now for Cleveland, Lane Thomas. Outside low, and a count 2-1. Right-handed reliever. This one chopped on the ground, but foul. Popped up. Thielen on the move. Tracks it down for the out. And that's the third out. One left for the Guardians, but they're on top 1-0. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Hunter Gaddis.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
And now the catcher comes up to him, Jake Rogers.
The catcher, Rogers.
Here's a 1-2. And another ball. Movement in the bullpen. Emmanuel Classe, the closer of the staff, is thrown. Sandler also getting ready. Here comes a pitch. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Pretty big strikeout right there to start this eighth inning. Down one. Any leadoff base runner really makes this inning a bit more interesting. But now this offense has to switch from possibly trying to manufacture a run to needing to run into something or just try to string multiple hits together to get a run across the plate.
Back to the top of the lineup, Akil Baddoo digs in now. Next offering is in for a strike.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Holding on to a one-run lead here in the bottom half of the eighth inning. Foul ball left side. He'll see another.
A little tardy on that fastball. He's going to have to get it going a little quicker. Get that front foot down.
Back to right. Settles underneath it. Calls it in. And there's two away.
Now back. Left fielder.
Here's the left fielder. Riley Green. Ball to strike. Out to short. Rocchio sends it to first. Inning over. Tigers fail to make any noise, and it remains 1-0. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Alex Lang.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Well, one-run game. Andrés Giménez digs in for the Guardians. And he deals. That's out to center field. Baddoo under it. Calls it in, and there's one away. And now the right fielder. One run game here in the top of the ninth. Very high with that one. And it's 2-1. Action in the pen down there. Matt Manning getting loose for A.J. Hinch. That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. And gone! And they add to the lead. It's 2-0.
A little more breathing room is always a good thing in baseball, and now they have it. Anytime you have a pitch down the middle of the plate, the percentages go up for the hitter to do damage, even if it's a pretty good sinker like that one. Nice piece of hitting there at the plate.
Base is empty, one away. And up next for Cleveland, Bo Naylor. One down, base is empty. Right through there for a strike. It's a strikeout. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Ryan Rocchio. That's ripped. Base hit. So now back to the top of the order.
Everything came together for him. Nice line drive to the pole side, met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, Angel Martinez. And another ball. Two outs. Wouldn't That's chase that hurt. Time.
swings through that.
Great hard last spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
And there's ball four.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner into scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
So they turn things over to the righty, Will Vest.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
So first and second with two outs. Kyle Mansardo digs in for the Guardians. The 1-1. Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
Wow, that's 89 on the gun, and it's a changeup. It's like good hitting if you're looking for it, but because of the speed differential between the fastball and that pitch, really hard for a hitter to get on time with it.
And the right-hander deals. Nope. That misses. 2-2. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. One run in the inning, but they lead two. Heart of the order, 3-4-5 will get their shot in the bottom of the ninth. It's the Guardians 2 and the Tigers nothing. We're back, and on the mound is the closer, Emmanuel Clase.
Save opportunity for him right here, and he's their guy. Time to lock this one down and get out of here with the W.
3-4-5 due up for the home team. Now it's the right fielder, Matt Wierlin.
Hey, look, we'll see how it factors in. I just can't emphasize how much that insurance run in the top of the ninth means. I mean, just such a big difference mentally when you're chasing two runs instead of one.
At the belt and fires. Fouls it off, still 1-2. Sends him down on strikes. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone. So the bullpen doing a nice job backing up the effort from their starter.
Yeah, we've seen some pretty excellent pitching out of this staff so far. I mean, they've come in ready to do their job and get outs. They've been pretty tough to get to in this one.
Righty delivers. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Just missed.
Wow, that's a tough pitch to lay off.
Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. The Tigers down by a pair here in the last half of inning number 9. That misses the zone. 3-2 now. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
This is definitely what a team likes to see out of their closer. Come in and just destroy all hope. First two batters, two strikeouts. See if he can strike out the side.
So it's their last chance in this one. Now it's the second baseman, Colt Heath. The pitch. Sends it to center, and that's going to do it. And that'll do it. The Guardians use three pitchers to combine for the shutout.
This team played extremely well to force this series into a game 5. It's just like a game 7. You win or go home. That game 5 should be a lot of fun to watch.
Here's another look at the numbers from this shutout victory.
Well, it takes a team effort to produce a shutout. I mean, sometimes you just got to tip your cap.
2-0, your final here in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
The final line for our ball game tonight. First, for the victorious Cleveland Guardians, 2 runs, 6 hits, no